Square and triangle met in a park earlier today.
We will have our first biology class tomorrow. Square, do you know what biology is?
I think we learn about the living things in biology.
Wait, but how do you know if something is living or not?
Biology, a definition. In the word biology, bio means life, and logy means the study of something. Therefore, biology is the study of life. In a simple word, biology is the study of living things. But then here's the question. How do you define living things? Alive describes something that is living. You are certainly alive, and the human beings around you who are talking and walking around are alive as well. You may also remember the animals in a zoo. Birds, bears, giraffe. They're alive as well. Now, an important characteristic of living things seems to be movement. But then, if you think about it more, trees don't walk around like humans, but they're alive. Flowers don't move either, but they're alive as well. The waves of oceans can wash the shore, which means they're moving, but waves in oceans are certainly considered as non-living. So if movements don't determine whether something is living or not, what are the true characteristics of living things? 1. Responsiveness to the environment. All living things respond to their environment. If you, who are certainly alive, feel cold, you'll turn on the heater or wear more clothes. However, a rock, which is non-living, won't have any actions no matter how cold it is. By responding and adjusting to an environment, organisms or living creatures can adapt and live better. 2. Growth and development. Do you know how you looked like when you were younger? Have you noticed that you may be a lot taller than a few years ago? All living organisms have the ability to grow and develop, but this is not the case for non-living things. If you have a teddy bear with you since you were a little child, you'll notice that it has never become bigger or taller. 3. Reproduction. All living things, whether that is referring to humans, animals, plants, or the small invisible species like bacterium, will reproduce or make more of themselves. This is important to living organisms because not able to reproduce brings the extinct of this type of species or the death of the last individual of this species. Imagine rabbits aren't able to reproduce and the number of them reduces because of the predators or hunters' activities. Soon there will be no rabbits on Earth. 4. Complex chemistry. All living organisms have a complex chemistry. From atoms to molecules, from energy processing to chemical reactions, the complex chemistry allows living things to stay alive. For example, you eat food and drink water every day. But why is that important? Substances called enzymes in your body will break down the food and soon they're transferred to energy for us to perform daily activities. 5. Homeostasis maintenance. Have you ever had a fever? This is an example of homeostasis imbalance. Homeostasis refers to the ability for our body to stay balanced internally no matter how the outside environment changes. For example, if you are walking in a desert and the temperature is very high, you will start to sweat, which will cause your body temperature to stay around 37 degrees Celsius but not increase with the outside temperature. 6. Organization. The simple substances come together and form complex things. Cells are the basic building structures of living organisms. A single bacterium is made up of a single cell, while humans are made up to trillion cells. Through a process called mitosis, the cells undergo division and replication, which makes more cells. A group of cells that perform a common function is called a tissue. Tissues that perform a common function form an organ. and organs that perform a common function form an organ system. And finally, all organ systems come together to form the organism, or the living things. 7. Passing traits on to offspring. Have you ever noticed that siblings always look alike? This is because of a molecule called DNA in our cells. When organisms reproduce, the DNA is passed on to the offspring, which brings certain traits of the parents to the offspring as well. That's it for the 7 characteristics of living organisms. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.